I spy.
Hey guys, here's the project I spy. First off, I want to talk about the shape of the eye. We want to make sure that we are not making the shape of the eye like a football. The eye is not like the shape of a football. Football is symmetrical from side to side and from up to down. A human eye is not symmetrical. So it's not the shape of football. We want to make sure that the curve of the eye is correct. So as it curves up and then smooths down, and then the bottom of the lid kind of goes straight across and then curves up. You can see with the arrows, which I'm going to make right here, that the bottom of the eye kind of goes straight across and then sharply curves up, and then the top of the eye slowly slants up and then sharp slant down. Now guys, with this eye project, we really want to talk about reference points. So let's talk about the anatomy of the eye first, and then we can really use the anatomy of the eye for reference points. Dark area of the eye is the pupil. The color is the iris. Then we have the tear ducts. We also have the upper eyelid and the lower eyelid. And then we have the eyelashes, the fold of the eye, and the brow. Now with the reference points, it lets us be able to judge the relationships of the anatomy of the eye. So the first area of the eye that we're going to talk about is the iris. The iris is a nice circle, so therefore we're going to use a circle to start off with our eye. This lets us make sure that for one, we're using the space of the page, and for two, it's easy then to judge the relationship of the other anatomy. So example, the upper lid and the lower lid, we can see that the upper lid overlaps the upper area of the iris, and then the lower lid is not touching the bottom of the iris, but it's really close. Our next reference points will be the corners of the eye. We really need to make sure that the corners are the correct distance from the sides of the iris. We don't want it to be too far away, because then the eye appears to kind of be closed, and we don't want it to be too close. So really try to find those reference points and use them. Here again are the arrows to show you how the lids work around the iris. Next reference points is to see the relationship between the top lid to the fold of the eye. You need to see how close the fold of the eye is to that top lid. Also check to see the corners of your eye, where the corners of your eye stop compared to the edges of that fold, and where they stop. They might extend past where the corners of the eye are, or they might be very close to where the corners of the eye stop. Now I'm placing in my pupil and also my light source in the eye. My last reference point is the distance between the fold in the eye to the eyebrow. Now that I have all my reference points done, I have my rough draft done. I don't need any more detail than this. So I'm going to take my rough draft and my final paper. I'm going to place my final paper on top of my rough draft paper. I'm going to take it to the tracing box, the light box, and I'm going to trace the image onto my final paper. Make sure that you draw lightly. Here's the medium that we're going to be using. We're going to be using oil pastels. It's a lot like crayon. Crayon's made of wax, where pastel, the base is oil. It's really nice for blending. So here I am, I'm placing on my lighter flesh tone. I'm really working it in the direction in which I see it work on the picture. Really works in the direction in which my eyelids worked, in that same direction. So really you need to work in that direction so that it appears to be real. If you scribble, it's gonna look like there's something wrong with it. So after you place the oil pastel on down onto the paper, then you rub it in with your finger, and therefore it gives a nice powdered tone, powdered look to it. It creates that flesh texture. Now what I'm doing is I'm slowly adding in other flesh tones. Where I see just a little bit of pink, I'm adding in just a little bit of pink. And where I see the flesh tone might be a little darker, then I add in some darker flesh tones, maybe a lighter brown to it, and then I blend it together. I'm gonna just continue to layer flesh tones on top of flesh tones. Therefore, it appears as how actual skin appears, which is layered. Now I'm gonna slowly also work in the eye shadow, which is the makeup of the eye. It appears to be a nice dark purple, so I'm slowly adding in a little bit of pink and then purple on top, and then slowly adding a darker purple and blending it together. Now what I'm doing is I'm adding in the shadow of the fold of the eye. What's closest to the fold is really, really dark, and as it works to the top eyelid, works out onto the top eyelid, it has a nice gradual value change, and that shadow gets lighter and lighter. So I'm just gonna slowly work layer on top of layer. Start off with a light brown, then get to a dark brown, and then eventually get to black. Now I'm adding in some areas where the light is reflecting off of the skin. So I'm using white to do that with. And I'm just slowly adding in details that I see from my picture. Now I realize that I might sound like a broken record, but I cannot talk about it more, is the direction in which you move. If you can see the direction in which the eyebrow moves, you have to move in that direction, or it just doesn't appear to be right. It doesn't appear to be hair. With all the layers that I've placed on my eyelids and on the skin, I've tried to move in the direction in which I see it come from that image. And I need you, and you're expected to do the same with the eye that you choose. Now guys, here's warning to your eye. Once you start adding in black and your darkest of darks, you need to be very, very careful. Make sure that keep your fingers clean after you blend your color together. If you have to wash them, then wash your fingers. But once you start touching the image after you've touched that black, then it's just gonna make your image a mess. So just be careful when you start using black. Now once you're done with all the outer areas, like the eyelids and the eyebrow and all the flesh, then you're going to be able to start on your iris. Your iris should be one of the last things you do. Unfortunately, a lot of students like to start off with that first, just because it is the area of the eye that takes on most of the attention. But once again, we need to talk about the direction which the iris moves. The iris moves from the outside in to the inside out. So therefore, as you apply layers, you need to continue to work in that direction. As you can see, I'm slowly adding the darker colors. The lightest color that I see in the iris of this eye that I've chosen is yellow, so therefore the first layer I did the whole iris yellow, and now I'm adding on the second layer, which is brown. I'm starting on the outer area and making it darker, and then the inner area and working out. That's because the most outer area of the iris is one of the darker areas of the iris. And again, that same with the inner part of the iris. So you can see that I'm slowly adding a darker brown and a darker brown. Eventually, I'm gonna add in black and then blend it. And again, when I'm blending it, I'm making sure that I'm working in the same direction from the outside in and from the inside out. Now I'm adding in the shadow, in which appears the shadow is casted from the upper lid. Some pictures have it, all depends on where your light source is coming from. Now I'm gonna take white and I'm going to add white into the light source of the eye. The light source of the eye is extremely important. It really brings life to the eye. If you don't have the light source or forget your light source, then unfortunately your eye will appear to be lifeless. Now next, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to add white into the whites of my eye. Even though my paper is still white, I'm going to add in that texture, and then I'm also going to add in some gray oil pastel to it so that the eye appears to be round. If you don't do this, then your eye will appear to be flat. Now onto the last part of the project. We're gonna save the eyelashes for last because it's easier to place them onto the image than it is to work around the eyelashes. It's very important to make sure that you understand the direction in which the eyelashes move. You really need to just take your time and place on each eyelash carefully, individually. Make sure that as you work to the outer corner of the eye, that you make those eyelashes get longer and darker also. You know, make sure that you're trying to give the reality, whether they are clumped together, whether they curve over to the left or curve over to the right, make sure that you're really capturing the reality of what you see on the image. Here's the final product, guys. I hope that you enjoy this assignment, and I hope that you improve as artists.